Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
Today we'll be doing another important grammar chapter, which is direct and indirect speech. We should also remember that this direct and indirect speech is a very important part of what? Of the transformation exercise that we are given to do in class 10 as well as 12. In 9, 10, 11, 12, you get this exercise, the transformation exercises, do as directed. In it, at least one, you will obviously get direct and indirect, where either you will be told to change it into indirect or direct. How you will be given to do that? You will be told to begin the sentence with a few words, and then you will see that it means that you have to change it to the indirect speech or direct speech. So for that you should know the chapter very well, otherwise you will not be able to get that 1 or 2 mark, isn't it? And even if you are not in class 9, 10 or 11 and 12, even then this chapter is very important. Why? Because direct and indirect speech is taught to class 6, 7, 8 also. Okay, so we will see this chapter, we will listen to what you will listen to what I am saying, and you will try to understand. If you have questions, you'll obviously ask in the comment section, and most importantly, you will be getting all the important chapters that is taught in class 9, 10, 11, 12, all the transformation exercises separately. It will be solved, and then you will have your prepositions and tenses and everything. First, let us finish off with direct and indirect speech. See, we may report the words of a speaker in two ways. In how many ways? In two ways we can report what we are trying to say. How? The first way is we can say it in a direct speech. What do you mean what do you mean by direct speech? It means when you are directly saying something. For example, if you are directly saying, give me a glass of water. This is a direct speech because you are directly saying what you want to say. Then you can also say it what he said without quoting. If I have to say, my friend said, give me a glass of water. What does this mean? This means that the friend is asking for a glass of water. I am not asking, but my friend is asking. So how do I say it? My friend said, comma, quotes, give me a glass of water. From here, I am trying to say that my friend wanted a glass of water. But how you are saying with the quotes? So it is a direct speech. What is an indirect speech? Where you do not use this quote. Where I do not use the quote, and then how do I say it? My friend asked for a glass of water. We are not giving the quotes. We are not saying, give me a glass of water. But we are writing in a simple sentence, a simple assertive sentence. So these are the two forms. One is the direct form and one is the indirect form. The indirect form does not use the quotations or does not use the direct form of the speech. Okay, let's see one example. Rama said, I am very busy now. What is this? First, we have this, the quotations. What does this quotation mean? That this is obviously a direct speech because we are directly saying what Rama said. This I am very busy. This I does not mean myself, but it means who? This one, Rama, isn't it? But in the same way, if you are talking about the same sentence in the indirect form, how will you say it? Then I will no more be I. It will be changed to he, because Rama is a boy and we are saying that Rama said that he was very busy then. So then we are not saying in a direct form, we are not saying I am very busy now. We are saying it in a different form where we do not use the quotations. We do not use the quotations anymore over here. We directly come to the topic, or we directly say what he was saying. Okay, Rama said that he was very busy then. Let's move to the important points over here. In direct speech, I have already said, what do we use? We use inverted commas. Okay, where can I show you this? This one. Inverted commas we are using in this sentence, isn't it? There are inverted commas. Next, mark off the exact words. With the inverted commas, what do we state? We state the exact words. For example, the teacher told me, bring your copy to me. So the teacher is saying this. The teacher's exact words I am saying. Teacher exactly used which words? Bring your copy to me. Okay. So these are not my words. These are my teacher's words. And I am quoting them completely as it was said. Okay, so exact words. In indirect speech, we do not. In indirect speech, we never use the exact words. We change it in a proper form without the quotes. Next, it will be further noticed that in changing the above direct speech into indirect, certain changes have been made. So obviously, when we are changing from the direct speech to the indirect speech, there will be some changes. What are the changes? We have used the conjunction that before the indirect statement. See over here in this sentence again, let's come to this. When we change the direct to the indirect, what else do we use? We use an extra word that, isn't it? Where do we use this? Just after said, isn't it? Just after said, we no more use this quotations or the comma, isn't it? And we directly place this word that over here. Okay, first, in indirect sentences, in a simple sentence, we will use this word that. What else? The pronoun I is changed to he. I was talking about this, na? The teacher said, bring your copy to me. So the teacher is saying this. So we will have to place, you have to change that word me into the teacher. For example, if you again come to this sentence, see, Rama said, I am very busy now, isn't it? But this I, the I is going to change into what? This I is going to change into he. Why? Why is it going to change into he? Because you are stating it in an indirect form, isn't it? You are stating it in an indirect form. So this I is going to change into he. So this is another change. One more change you will notice. What is that? The verb am is changed to what? Is changed to was. Let's come to that example once more. This am, here is the word am. This is changing to what? This is changing to was. So we can understand that the simple present tense is changing to what? The simple past tense. Am is simple present tense. It is changing into what? It is changing into simple past tense. This is very logical. For example, if I say that I am teaching you direct and indirect speech, now I am doing it. But after some time, I will no longer be doing that, isn't it? That will become a past. So if you say my words to your mother, then how will you say it? You will say it in a present tense? No, you will say it in the past form. Why? Because this work is already done. This event has become a past event, isn't it? So it will be changed to past forms. Okay. Now there is also a way how you will change this into past forms that you will know. The adverb now is then changed to then. Now again we will come to the sentence. See this now. We have used this now. We are talking about the present time. But in the indirect speech, we are no more talking about that present time. The teacher had asked for the copy and that has become a past. So as it is a past event, we will change the word now into then. It is a bit complicated over here. It may seem a bit complicated, but we'll make it easier. We will see a picture for this. Let's take an example. This morning, your stomach started paining. Your mother called the doctor. The doctor has come and he is talking to you. This is an event. Okay, what is happening over here? The doctor has come to you and he is going to treat you and he is talking to you. Okay, let's see. What is the doctor saying? What did you eat last night? Now the child is sick, obviously. So the doctor asks him, what did you eat last night? So what is this? Direct speech or indirect? Yes, it is the direct speech because the doctor is directly talking to you. Okay. What is the boy saying? I just had rice and chicken curry yesterday. So the boy is answering him. He is answering the doctor. What is he answering? He's saying that he had rice and chicken curry yesterday. So this is also a direct speech. Nobody else is talking for the boy. The boy is directly talking to the doctor. Okay. Now if I have to say the boy's words, then how will I say? I will say that the boy said that he just had, we will change the word just because just has become a past. So we will no more use the word just. I will change into what? I will change into he. He had, this one will remain the same. And one extra word we will add. He had is a simple past tense. So a simple past tense will change into past perfect form. So you will have to say he had rice and chicken curry. And yesterday will no more be that yesterday. For example, maybe I'm talking about this incident after 2 years, then how will I say? The previous day. That is no more a yesterday, so it will become the previous day. So how many changes? One, I will change into he. Second, the simple past tense will change into past perfect tense. And the last one, yesterday, will change into the day before. Now separately we will study this again. I'll make this very easy for you. Just finish the class. What is a reporting verb? Let's see what is a reporting verb. See, follow these sentences. The boy said, I am very angry. The boy says, I am very, very angry. Number three, the boy will say, I am very angry. What is changing over here? Can you find out? See, said. This one is says. This one is will say. What does this say? First one is the past tense. Second one is the present tense. And the third one is the future tense. We have to remember, first point, we have to remember that only if it is a past tense, only, I'll highlight this, only if it is a past tense, this is called the reporting verb, okay? Said, says, will say, these all are the reporting verb. Now we know the reporting verb. When you are given to change a direct sentence into an indirect sentence or an indirect sentence into a direct sentence, you will have to remember that you have to find out these reporting verbs. Okay, first you'll find out the reporting verbs. So when you have found it out, you will see in which tense it is written. First one is past, second one is present, third one is future. Only if the reporting verb is in the past tense, that means in the first case, if it is in the past tense, only then the tense inside the quotations will change. Otherwise, it will not change. Okay. In this case, in the second case and in the third case, what are the reporting verbs tense? It is future. First one is a second one is the present tense. Third one is the future tense. So in case of present and future tense, nothing will. The tense inside the quotations will not change. This one, these are not going to change. Only in case of past tense, it is going to change. Now, how will it change? Okay, first part is clear. How will it change? Let me read this one for you once. When the reporting or the principal verb is in the past tense, all present tense of direct are changed into the corresponding past tenses. This is what I said. If these, you will have to check these reporting verbs. If it is in past tense, change the tense inside. If it is not in the past tense, then you don't have to change the tenses inside. Okay, clear? Next, we will move to understanding this, that how will these tenses change? How will we change this? We know that we have to change it, but how will we change this? If it is in the past tense, then how will we change the tense inside? We will follow this. Okay, this is another important thing. The simple present tense becomes a simple past tense. For example, see, here is what said. So the tense inside will change. How will it change? I will write, he said that I will change to he. Normally it will change to he because who is I? I is that he whom we were talking about. So he said that he am will change to what? Into simple past, because this is present. It will change into simple past when we are changing to indirect. So it will become was. That means past. So simple present will change to simple past. Next, a present continuous will become a past continuous. If the same sentence was written in a present continuous form, for example, my master is writing letters. Okay, what is given? My master is writing. So this is obviously present continuous. How will we change it? We will change into past continuous. Was writing. Is writing will change to was writing. Clear? Next, a present perfect becomes a past perfect. If it is written in present perfect, that is if I say, he said, I have come to your house, then this will change to, I had come to your house. Isn't it? Because have come is present perfect, it will change to past perfect. What is the example given here? I have passed the examination. Now this is present perfect, it will change into past perfect. What? Had passed. Clear? The simple past in the direct becomes the past perfect in the indirect. So now if this was present tense, then it would be changed into simple past, isn't it? The horse dies in the night. If it was this, then what would it be? The horse died in the night. But if it is died in the indirect, in the direct speech itself, if it, see the sentence, the sentence says that it is, the horse died, isn't it? So in this case, we have the past tense over here. We have the past tense over here. So how will you change this one? You will change into the past perfect. Directly, we will change the past into the past perfect. So once we will revise, if it is in present tense, simple present tense, you will change it to simple past. If it is in present continuous, you change it to past continuous. If it is in past perfect, if it is in present perfect, you change it to past perfect. If it is in simple past, you change it to past perfect. And if it is past perfect, you keep it as past perfect. If it was, I had worked in his house, then you will keep it as he had worked in his house. Same, because there is nothing more past than the past perfect. Past perfect is the last form. You cannot change more from that, isn't it? More past even cannot take place. Past perfect is the extreme. So you just keep it like that. Okay. So note, the shall of the future tense, if it is in future tense, for example, if the sentence is I will go to your house, then it will become he would, will change to would, shall will change to should, then can would change to could, okay, will would change to would, as I said. Okay, next. But all these changes will take place only when the reporting verb is in the past tense. If the reporting verb is not in the past tense, if this one is not in the past tense, then nothing will change. No tense will change. Only I will change to he, and these things will change. Otherwise, tenses, there will be no changes in the tenses. Next, we'll move to a very easy topic. A part of it. Okay, what is it? The tenses may not change even when the reporting verb is in past tense. Then also the tenses will not change. Why? If it is a habitual truth. What do you mean by habitual truth? Habitual truth means, for example, every day I do something. Every day I jog. Every day I drink water in the morning. Every day I go to school. These are daily events, isn't it? So if you find words like daily, every day, usually, normally, this means what? This means that this is a habitual truth. Normally, it is a habit. You do it always. So then you will not change the tense inside, even if the reporting verb is in past tense. Normally we have come to know what? That if this reporting verb is in past tense, then the tenses inside will change. But over here it will not change because this is a habitual truth. Clear? Okay, clear? Next, a universal truth. This is another case where even if you find that the reporting verb is in past tense, the tense inside will not change. Why? Because it is a universal truth. This is never going to be a past event, isn't it? The earth revolves around the sun. Will this ever change? No, this is always the present form. This is never going to be a past. It is not like this that I told you I'm having a stomach upset and tomorrow it will become a past event. Tomorrow my stomach ache will be a past event, isn't it? So that is not going to happen in this case, because every day the earth is going around the sun. So that is why the tense here will not change. Next. Now you will just have to, most of the important things we have done. Now you will have to remember these words. Now, when you change the direct speech into indirect speech in a sentence, if you find words like now, change it to then. If you find words like here, for example, I am here, then it will become he was there. If it was ago, it becomes before. If it is today, this is very important. Okay, remember these. If it is today, I am going home today. Then how you will change it? You will say that he was going home that day. If it was tomorrow, how will you change it? He was going home. He was going home the day after. Either you can say day after or you say the next day. Anything. If it is given that I will go home or I went home yesterday, then this yesterday word will become the previous day. When will these things change? Only when you are changing the direct speech to an indirect speech and you find a sentence with these words. These words will change like this. If it was last night, what you will do it? The night before. If you find it is this, then it will become it was that. This will change to that. If it was these, then it will become those. Okay. This much, at least this much you remember. Okay, you memorize. Other than that, you don't have to memorize anything. Rest of it, you just When you practice more, you will be able to do all the exercises. It will not be a problem. Just remember these few. Okay. Next, we'll move to few exercises. Only 5 sentences. Okay. We have only one exercise and we will do these 5 sentences and then it will be over. Change into indirect speech. You have to change the sentences into the indirect speech. See, Ranjana said to me, what is the reporting verb? Said. Try on your own. Okay. Said. What is said? Said means it is the reporting verb is in the past tense. Okay. So when it is said to, you can change the whole thing to told. Then how you will change it? Ranjana will be the same. So Ranjana said to, change it to told. So Ranjana told me. Now you have the quotes and the comma. What will you write over here in case of direct speech? You will write that. So Ranjana told me that. This much is okay. Now what is here? I. Who is I? I is Ranjana because Ranjana is talking in direct speech. Isn't it? So Ranjana told me that she. You have to change the tense over here because reporting verb is in past tense. This one will become, this is simple present tense. You change it to simple past. So it will become she was sick. Ranjana told me that she was sick. Clear? Number two. Let's come to number two. What is the reporting verb? Says. Very important. What is this? Simple present tense. So the tense inside is not going to change. It will remain present continuous. Okay. Now see. Akash will remain Akash. We are changing to indirect. So first word is Akash. Says remains as says. So Akash says. Now comes the comma and the quotes. What will you change over here? It will become that. Akash says that. Now who is I? I is Akash. So Akash says that he. Now am going. Now after he, I cannot use am, isn't it? So I will keep it in this present continuous, but I'll change the word that he is going. This is also present continuous. Just I changed am going to is going. Why? Because I'm no more writing I over here. I'm changing the word I over here because it is Akash. I have to put he over here. So Akash says that he is going to watch a football match. And then today will become what? This one will change. Only tense will not change if the reporting verb is in present or future. But the rest of the things will change. I will change to he. Then today will change to that day. Correct. Very good. Next, number three. Satish said. What is the reporting verb? Reporting verb is in past tense. Now obviously the tense will change inside. Let's see if it changes. Now you have the comma and the quotes. This one will change to that. So Satish said that the earth is round. Tense will not change over here. Why? Because this is the universal truth. Isn't it? This is the universal truth. In case of universal truth, it will always remain the same. The earth is round, obviously. So this is not going to change. That is why tense will not change over here. Next, we'll move to sentence number 4. My father told me. This is okay. Reporting verb is in past tense. We have to change the tense inside. My father told me I was not going to office yesterday. This one is wrong. That will not be here. Okay. My father told me that I will change to what? Now try on your own. I will change to he because who is I? I is father. My father told me that he was not going. So this one is what? Past continuous. So you will have to change it into perfect continuous, past perfect continuous. How will you change it? My father told me that he had not been going to office. What will happen to yesterday? The day before. Okay. This one is a little bit difficult. This is the present. This is the past continuous form over here. So you will have to change it into the more past form. What is the more past form? That is the past perfect form. So because it is continuous also, so you make it past perfect continuous. So he had not been going to office the day before because it is yesterday. Okay. Next, number 5, the last one for today. Arjun said to Vikas. So said to, reporting verb is in past tense. So Arjun told Vikas, change it to told. You can change it to told. If you keep it as it is, said to, it is correct. But you can also change the said to into told. So Arjun told Vikas. Then this one. This one will become that. Arjun told Vikas that. Who is you? Arjun is talking to Vikas. when I am talking to you, how am I talking to you? I'm saying you like that. So you is who? You is Vikas. So Arjun told Vikas that he will changes to what? Would. He would never find the book. Okay, I guess this part is clear. Okay, if it is not clear, if you have any other sentence that you want to ask, you can write it in the comment section. Or if you the next part is the interrogative form. So before that, I want to see some questions that you will ask me so that it is clear to you. Interrogative sentences are a little bit difficult. Okay, the only difficult part of direct indirect speech. So before that, try to find out if you have any problem in these sentences. Okay, all the explanations that I gave you, I guess it is clear. You also check, and if you find out any other problem that you face, please write in the comment section. Tell your friends to like, comment and subscribe and see the videos so that it can help them out too. Thank you so much. Bye bye.